A very good morning once again. Welcome to Urban Today. My name is Lynn Komjisha, and we're glad you're watching. Please be part of the conversation on your social media. Go to Urban Television, that is on Facebook, at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter, Lynn UG3 on Twitter, as well as Mubarak UG on Twitter, and the same on Facebook. We are looking at a lot of issues today morning, but in particular, as you're aware, the Electoral Commission is mandated by the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda to organize, conduct, and supervise elections and referenda. Now, in fulfillment of this, the Electoral Commission has embarked on preparations to conduct the 2020-2021 general elections. Now, according to the revised roadmap, the Commission will commence the electoral program with the conduct of the elections of the special interest groups. Yes, as we shall see which interest groups these are and who is eligible and why they are doing that and why they picked out them first, will be conducted taking into consideration, of course, the standard operating procedures. Now, joining me this morning in that regard is Mr. Frederick Mwaya Tirakuno, and he is the District Registrar, Returning Officer, Kampala District, and also explain to us who the special interest groups are, why they have picked on them, why they are starting with them, and how far the electoral roadmap has gone. Sir, a very good morning and welcome to the show.
Good morning, Lynn, and our viewers.
Right. How far has the Electoral Commission gone, of course, with the implementation of the roadmap?
The Electoral Commission, as we stand right now, has in place the National Voters Register. I believe that our viewers out there, every Ugandan now can check using the digital platforms to know whether they are on the register. Mm. And at the moment, we have produced the specific voters registers for the older persons, the youth, and the persons with disability, because those are the elections we are conducting right now at the moment.
Right.
Yep.
Who are those special interest groups, people?
The special interest groups are more than what we are dealing with right now. But the ones we're dealing with right now are the older persons, that is persons who are 60 years and above.
Yes.
The youth, that is persons who are by 23rd of December last year had not made 30.
Mm-hmm.
And then the persons with disability.
Oh, wow.
Those are
the special interest groups.
Those are the three
about.
Special interest groups you're dealing
okay.
with.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, those are the three, the youth, the persons with disabilities, mm-hmm. and of course the older persons.
Yes.
Now, in doing that, why did you start with them first of all? Is that the usual order?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Apparently, that is the usual order because
right.
eventually it is through these groups that they get representation to mm. other levels. Mm. For instance, if you take the youth structures,
mm-hmm.
we are starting tomorrow, the 11th, with the older persons. On the 13th, we shall have elections for the persons with disability, and on the 17th, when we conduct the elections of the village executives
mm-hmm.
of the youth structures, the youth structures will now move up to the parish level,
mm-hmm.
to the sub-county level, municipality level, where the municipalities, and then to the district level.
That's
then the
right.
district councils, the district executives have representatives who go to form the National Electoral College.
So we have councils and committees.
Yeah.
This is what we are going into tomorrow,
yes.
starting tomorrow.
That's it.
In every sub-county?
In every village.
Village.
Yes. In every village.
Mm-hmm.
For older persons tomorrow.
Yes.
13th for the persons with disability and 17th for the youth.
For the youth.
And basically, the reason you were asking why we start with these structures
yes.
It is because they are the ones who will eventually elect the councillors representing the youth to the local councils, which form part of the local governments. Mm-hmm. They are the ones who are going to elect the representative of the youth to parliament in their respective regions.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Now, which categories of these special interest groups are conducting elections during this particular program? You're saying the youth, the elderly, the persons with disabilities. Yes. Can I also go and vote? Do I just go and vote? How do I take part? And what do I need?
Yeah, if you fall in each of their respective categories, which means you are on our register. Mm-hmm. For instance, if you belong to a village of Kagugube, and you are 30 years, you are below 30 years by the date of 23rd December 2019, then it means that you actually are on the register for the youth in Kagugube village. Mm. So anyone,
those are separate
so
registers.
Every youth, okay, who is in who resides in Kagugube and is on that register will be able to vote.
There's a special register separate.
Yeah, that is separate. It has been extracted from the National Voters Register. And it is best village based.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it, only that person qualifies if you're 30.
If you were 30 below 30 by the date of 23rd December 2019. Mm. Yeah, then you are on that register and you qualify.
How are they going to conduct these elections?
These elections are going to be conducted by lining up behind the candidate, behind the agent, behind the symbol or the poster of the intending candidate.
Mm.
Yeah.
Lining up scientifically or
the
usual?
The word scientific is not really our word. That is a coinage by the public. But basically, it is only our campaigns which we are referring to as digital.
Okay.
But otherwise, the rest of the activities, the nominations and so forth, they are being conducted in the normal, usual way, except that we are observing the standard operating procedures.
That's right.
As agreed with the Ministry of Health. Mm. And on that basis, we are asking all the people who come to participate in these elections to observe those principles, to wear masks, to social distance, and also to sanitize.
That's right.
Yeah.
As we get to that later, do we know how many villages, cells that will, these elections will be conducted in?
Yes, we the villages we have in the country are closing in on 70,000.
Wow.
69,648, thereabout. Mm-hmm. And basically, we are conducting the elections in all these villages.
Mm.
Yes, starting tomorrow.
Do you have manpower? Do you have the money? Is everything in place?
Yeah, everything is in place. Mm. We have done the recruitment of the officials who will be conducting these elections.
Mm-hmm.
At the moment, we have finished the training of those officials. I think today they are receiving all the requirements and equipment they need because early tomorrow, they have to be at their village centers to start conducting
the
election.
That's good. So people out there, the youth, the elderly, the persons with disabilities, please prepare yourselves to go and vote tomorrow, to go and vote for your leaders. You said, so these registers of youth, of elderly, of persons with disabilities were extracted from the national register.
Yeah.
Do we know how many of them there are?
At the moment, I don't have the total figure the cuff, but it is upwards of 15 million.
15 million?
Yeah.
Combined of all the
of
three
all the
categories.
Voters, yeah. Oh, no, I'm talking about the National Voters Register.
Ah.
Yes.
So we have some of them, the youth, some of them the elderly. Mm. And persons with disabilities extracted from
and
that.
The rest of us who are actually that is now the total of all registered Ugandans.
Wow. That's good. Mm. That's really good. Now, so you mentioned that they're going to line up.
Yes, behind the candidate of preference.
Of preference. This is at the local, well, this is at the village level.
At the village level, at the parish level, at the sub-county level. Mm-hmm. Now, when you get to the district level, that's when
it becomes a
secret ballot.
Ah.
Yeah.
Secret ballot. Interesting. So, you mentioned SOPs are in place. People have masks. Mm. The ones going to carry out the election.
Our officials will be masked. Mm-hmm. They will be social distanced. Mm-hmm. They will be having a sanitizer at their table. Mm-hmm. They will also provide water and soap for all the persons who are coming and accessing the polling center. Make sure that they have washed their hands and they have accessed the center and are social distancing. Mm. Yes, please.
So what are the requirements? Let's talk about, okay, assuming I'm a youth and I want to go and vote, what should I carry? My ID? Should I carry my driver's license? Should I carry my passport? Or just come and you say, my name is so-and-so?
You see, usually when you are in a village, it is easier for you to be identified by the people around you.
Yeah, that's very right.
So I would imagine someone would not be chased and probably rejected at a center, basing on that. Mm. That's different from sometimes polling stations, which combine several villages and so forth.
That's true.
But to be on the safe side, I think one would be better off coming with their national ID, so that they can easily identify themselves in case there is any doubt as to who they are vis-a-vis the register.
That's very right. Mm. Okay, so carry your national ID, but let me ask a question. Mm. People always say, voting, I don't want to vote. Is there a way you have educated, has the election commission, you know, gone down to educate people on the importance of their vote? Do people know that voting is very important?
We have tried under the circumstances,
yes,
to make sure that we mobilize the people, especially their special interest groups in their respective categories, to make sure that they take this election seriously, that they know that whatever the outcome will be, whoever will be their councillor, whoever will be their member of parliament, will come out of this process. Mm-hmm. So it is very important for them to take it seriously.
That's right.
And we believe we have been heard, and we believe that these are serious people who will consider seriously what we have told them.
Okay.
Yes.
There's a point you mentioned that the youth, for example, I'm using the youth because most of us are youth. Mm. So now, the youth vote at the village level.
Yes.
From the village level, they go to the parish.
Yeah, so basically, the youth have an executive of 9 people.
Yes.
At the village. Mm-hmm. Now, if we have a parish of, let's say, a parish like Lubia, in Rubaga, such a parish would produce about 9 people per village, and that would mean you combine the 9 people from each of the villages. When we talk about Lubia, if you talk about 13 villages, you bring together all the 9 from each of the 13 villages.
Okay.
And those people will come together and they will form the council at the parish level. The committees from each village come together and they form a council of the parish.
Yes.
And then they also elect a committee for the parish. Mm-hmm. And that is committee of the parish is the one which moves ahead to the sub-county. And the committee of the sub-county, the committees of the different parishes at the sub-county will come together and form the council of the sub-county. And it goes ahead up to the district level, and then we move on to the national level.
Why I asked that is because I hear a lot about electoral colleges. Mm. Is that what you just explained?
Apparently.
Wow.
Because from village level, it is basically all the youth are the voters.
Mm.
The moment you leave the village level, it becomes an electoral college.
Uh-huh.
That is to say, the nine from each village represent the voters in that, the youth in that village to go and vote the executive.
From the parish to the sub-county to the, and eventually to the district.
Yeah.
Wow. Most people don't actually know what electoral college is.
Mm-hmm.
So I like that you have explained. And I would like to emphasize that at the village level, they will elect nine of their representatives. Now, the nine will go to the parish. Those still nine, yes, will also elect some others to the sub-county.
Sure.
Wow. That's the electoral college, in precisely put. Well, we also see that these elections, so what will happen after the elections? They happen at the village level. You've already told us that the councils will move to the parish and, you know, do all that. Is that all that will happen after?
Thereafter, of course, when we have these committees constituted for all those categories, we as Electoral Commission we would have done our job, and we would compile a report. We compile a report for each of the categories.
Mm-hmm.
We'll compile lists of executives at all the levels, and we'll forward them to the Minister of Gender.
And they will be gazetted.
They will be gazetted, yes. And then we'll give them to the Minister of Gender to start from there.
Okay.
Because the administration of those categories is actually in the Minister
in
of
the
Gender.
In the Minister of Gender.
Yes, please.
All right. Are there any other categories of special interest groups? And when are they conducting the elections?
Yeah, we have other categories of special interest groups. We have the workers.
Mm-hmm.
We have the army.
Mm-hmm.
We have the women.
Mm-hmm.
They will also have their committees constituted at a later time. The workers' committees, we shall start their constitution sometime later this month.
Okay.
Yeah. We are supposed to have what we call the sub-county conferences for the non-unionized workers because eventually the non-unionized workers are supposed to come together with the unionized workers and then they will be able to elect their representatives to the different councils, that is the district council and the parliament as well. And also the other categories like the persons with disability. When we have the activities, they will also elect the members of parliament. The older persons, now the law has passed. We believe the president is going to assent to it.
Oh, yes. For
and
the,
then
for
there
the
will be also members of parliament for the older persons.
That's true.
Yeah. But later, we shall also have the elections of the members of the UPDF to represent the army in the parliament, and we shall also have the women coming on board.
Why didn't the Electoral Commission conduct all these special interest groups elections at once?
Some of the other activity, the others do not necessarily lead towards the election of their parliamentarians. Like, for instance, the women, they are the women representatives to parliament are elected in every district, and they are elected by adult suffrage.
Oh, yes.
Everybody elects them.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, the women committees are only there as committees and executives to cater for the interests of the women, but not necessarily as electoral colleges to elect the women members of parliament. Even the army, we don't have committees elections from the very grassroots. So basically, that's why we don't have to do those elections early. Those will come at a time when the Electoral Commission deems fit. Actually, there is a program to that, except that I would not be comfortable going into that right now. since we want to emphasize,
focus on the special interest groups
right now.
These particular ones being the youth, the elderly, and of course the persons with disabilities. There's concern, there's concern that, well, these ones are going to be held normally by lining up, but there's concern about the electoral roadmap being a bit too scientific. Do you have any worries about that, or you think it's going to go through perfect?
Yeah, everything that is different is brings apprehension.
That's right.
Many times, but you see, every time determines every circumstance determines how you operate, and we all know that we have been invaded by this. Should I call it a monster called the COVID-19?
I think it's become one. Yes.
It is a big challenge all over the world. Actually, many people are taking this as a not a very serious matter.
Oh yes, that's true.
But if you look at what is happening to other countries, I think we need to take this matter very seriously, and also make sure that we don't play things as if it is business as usual. I think our lives and the lives of our voters is more important than any kind of process or procedure. So what is important is for us to follow the guidelines of the Minister of Health.
That's right.
Because they have been given the responsibility to protect our health, to protect the public, and so it is important that we follow suit.
When you say we follow suit and we follow the guidelines of the Ministry of Health, my concern goes back to that lining up. Not everyone is going to wear a mask, but I know the government of Uganda has actually issued out masks to people and is still issuing them out. But people need to carry, you need to wear a mask to go and vote.
Sure.
Those of you are going to line up. Wear a mask. In social distancing is very, very vital. Don't go coughing. And this is in the village. Everyone wants to go and cough. Well, so let me. We are still talking about the measures and of course how the Electoral Commission is doing that. He highlighted earlier how the Electoral Commission is has put in place measures, of course, to combat further spread of COVID-19. Apart from giving soap, apart from giving the sanitizer, apart from for making sure that your officials have masks and social distancing and blah blah blah, what else? Do you have people manning the entrances or manning the electoral area to make sure people actually follow up on those things?
Yeah, we are going to have a specific designated official at every polling station to make sure that they enforce those standard operating procedures.
Right.
We shall have a polling constable. We believe, depending on the manpower of the police, in some places it will be real police, in some places it will be local defense, in some places it will be local vigilantes who can be mobilized to do that work. And we believe that we shall have order at those respective polling stations.
And in case we, in cases where we, is there an ambulance, a standby ambulance, for example, if anyone got a problem?
A problem as in?
I mean, I could fall sick, I could become, my temperature, for example, you take my temperature and it is high.
And it's high. We call the Minister of Health to take charge of that.
So from the village, imagine by the time you go to, you call the Minister of Health from the district to the village.
Yeah, but as you know, Lynn, the government has put in place all the measures. Actually, there are vehicles on standby, on 24-hour standby, just to handle the emergencies related to COVID-19.
That's right.
So basically, the Electoral Commission is not going to reinvent the wheel as far as managing of such cases or such suspected cases are concerned.
I want to pick your mind on something that caught my attention. We have seen some countries in the neighborhood, you know, carry out elections.
Yes.
And there's been a surge. We've seen surges of COVID-19. But have you studied? Has the Electoral Commission carried out studies on in regard to the countries in the neighborhood and Uganda? What have you, you know, discovered?
I don't think we have had the opportunity. You know that any kind of foreign travel was banned.
Any we kind. Can do things digitally.
Yeah, but from the information we have, we and also from advice we have from the Minister of Health, we know very well that if we observe the minimum standard operating procedures, we can really move along with this disease until such a time as we have a vaccine or even a cure. Yes, please.
And these things, these elections, well, we are worried. People are worried they're not going to be free and fair, but we'll see how that plays out. Now, if I could ask...
Why are people worried they will not
I know. Why don't you assure us that
yeah,
we should
because,
not be worried?
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. But that really, what is most important is that people are given the opportunity to make a choice. And that people are, the candidates are given an opportunity to reach
Prove
their people through the media that are available. And also that the facilities for elections are in place and they are transparent. And that our offices are open to all people of all persuasion. So that they can know exactly how we are conducting these activities. So I believe that the Electoral Commission has done their duty and they have proved themselves. We have put everything out on the table, and we believe that this is going to be a very free and very fair election.
There's talk that everything might actually just be normal in the near future. There's talk everywhere. It is just talk. What we know is that the election roadmap
is
digital.
In the grapevine?
Yes. So, yeah, we keep hearing stories, but we are not going to rely on stories that are unfounded.
That everything will be normal as far as
voting.
Voting or the campaigns. Or
and the campaigns. And
that we shall go back up on top of lorries and processions. I don't think so. I don't think so. I think we still have a big problem on our hands.
That's right.
And we need to take this matter very seriously.
Very seriously, because we're recording deaths, actually.
Sure.
I also foresee that in the next 5 years, if this works out, we might as well continue the trend. It might be the new normal. The digital way of campaigning might be the new normal. Is it something that we can actually, you know, adopt?
I highly doubt, knowing who we are.
Yes.
If there is a vaccine, if there is a cure for this COVID-19, I can assure you that if the public health act is not swung in action for any reason, and there is no reason for it to be swung in action,
right,
I would believe that the Ugandans I know will go back doing their thing.
Yeah,
and that would be perfectly okay.
Yeah.
But the moment there is a threat like we have right now,
right,
we need to take it seriously.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So we take seriously whatever is around us. Now, as we wind up, what is the program for nomination of candidates for local government, parliamentary, and presidential elections? I would like to know what's the program like.
Oh yeah, the parliamentary and local government. We have the nominations for local government between the 7th. And the 17th of September, 2020.
You know, this year has been very funny. I keep thinking that the year is almost ending. Like I feel like there's 1 month to go.
1 month to the end of the year.
It's been so long. Okay, so that is in September. Nomination.
Yes, that is September.
That is for local government.
7th to 17th.
Okay.
The specific dates for the specific levels of the local government will be communicated by the commission.
When that time comes.
Yes.
And also parliamentary.
Parliamentary will be on the 12th and the 13th of October, 2020.
We still have you guys. I'm already tired for this whole month. I rather for this whole year. But yes, there you have it. In October is when they do the parliamentary nominations.
Yes. And the presidential on the 2nd and the 3rd of November.
Wow. Mm. We're going into Christmas with all that.
Yes.
The primaries are going on for different...
For the different parties, yes.
Yes, for the different parties. When do we expect those ones to end?
Really, they should end before our nominations.
Ah, that is...
But we don't determine...
They have like a month to go.
We don't determine the programs of the parties.
Of course you
parties.
Don't. Of yep. course you don't. Okay. Mm. So for you, waiting for those nominations, the local government and parliamentary...
Yeah, we shall be expecting... whoever has gone through the primaries to be seconded to us for nomination.
Right, there you have it. For those things that, for those of you who are youth, if you're an elderly person, if you're a person with disability, this is the time. Tomorrow, they're electing the
older person.
The older person, yes. Bigger pardon. Now, if you're 60 years and above, if by the date of registration, which was last year in
the
December.
The cutoff was 23rd December.
23rd December. If by 23rd September, I rather December, you were 60.
You were already 60.
Already 60.
Yes.
You can go and vote. Mm. Tomorrow at your village, go with your national ID, just in case. Just in case. But most of these people are already known. If you are a youth, the youth are on the 13th.
The 17th.
17th.
Yeah.
Yes, 17th of this month.
Of August.
Of August, which is a few days away, and as well as persons with disabilities.
On the 13th.
On the 13th. Mm. So go get to vote. Please, you need people to represent you at different levels of leadership, and because you need them and they need you too. So go exercise your right and vote. We had with me... Mr. Fred Muwaya, who is also an election officer, of course, for Kampala District, I beg your pardon. And we're glad you made a date with us to explain these things. Special interest groups. Most of you didn't know about special interest groups, did you? Mm. And how the elections are going to be carried out. What caught my attention is that workers, UPDF, and other people, other special interest groups, are also going to have the elections carried out very soon.
Sure.
Yes. So thank you very much for making time.
Please.
And we hope that everything goes right and well.
Thank you very much for having me, Lynn. And I would like to thank the management of Urban TV and also to call upon the Ugandans to keep the peace.
Keep the peace
and take part in these elections.
Also stay healthy and safe.
Sure.
Yes. All right. Urban Today takes a break.